Very good. Very impressive.
It's one of the nicer restaurants in the city.
Bit of a contemporary sort of feel. Very good ambience.
Very fresh ingredients.
One of the best pieces of bacon I've ever had. The maple was very good.
Incredibly serviced, very proper. It's got a really nice art and artistic design as well. Friendly environment.
Thank you for joining us here on Meghan's Menu. I'm Meghan Duffy, and today is pretty exciting because we are going to be cooking food that is mainly local, it's organic, and a lot of it is fair trade. Joining us is Chef Steve here from Era Bistro, which is located in the Canadian Human Rights Museum.
Yes, it is.
So for those joining us who have never been to your restaurant, how would you describe it to people?
Well, it's a bistro-style restaurant, so it's fast service. We mainly do salad sandwiches, but as Meghan said, it's all local, organic, and fair trade, as much as possible. So we like to keep it light, fresh, and
delicious.
Just good tasting food, yeah.
Well, thanks for joining us. So what is going to be the first thing that we're making here on the menu?
Okay, first up, we're going to do our Beets by Arab. So this is probably my favorite salad on the menu. It's very light. We make it with local Boston purple beets, which we've just gone and steamed.
And the great thing with beets is that a lot of people have beets in Manitoba because they grow so easily here. I mean, my neighbors are dropping beets off like it's going out of style. I have lots of beets in my fridge.
Oh, exactly. I know my cellar is just packed full. So what I'm going to show you guys today is something that we do in industry, just to go and save as much of the beet as possible. A lot of people go, they sit there, they peel, they get their hands really purple. Nobody likes purple on the hands. You're going to take a clean cloth, and you're just going to rub. And when you rub, as you can see, it just slowly peels off just enough skin so you have as much beet as possible. You try and save as much nutrients, as much flavor.
Today is really exciting. We have two awesome ladies joining us. Here we have Leanne Cater and also her girlfriend, Kim. Okay, so here's a question. Now, obviously, like, you need to be using a rag that you're never really going to want to use ever again.
It will come out. It all depends on what you're using to wash.
You know, good old bleach does the trick, right?
Exactly, yeah. Exactly. Have you ever made whipped cream before?
All the time.
All the time? Yeah. Perfect. So you know how to do this.
I don't
have to explain anything.
It's on my first
day. Awesome. Just going to cut this up. Normally, we serve this chilled, just so it's a salad and it doesn't wilt. We're just going to cut some nice wedges here. So we're going to take a little bit of pepper, sprinkle over top of the beets, and a little bit of salt.
Okay, salt and pepper on the beets.
So we have a little bit of organic red Frescoli vinegar. So it's just a nice
Whoa, what is this? One more time.
Okay, organic red Frescoli. So Frescoli is a company down on Cordon. They do specially import vinegars and oils. We love them. They have some of the best selection in Winnipeg.
Okay, so two tablespoons of the fancy red wine vinegar.
We don't need to have really firm peaks on this. Okay, so all I've done here is taken a little bit of romaine, a little bit of iceberg, just whatever greens you have in house. This is what I like to use, and we also have this beautiful Neva Farm microgreens. This is red cabbage. So we're just gonna take a little bit of that as well.
Is this, if you cut it, will it regrow back?
Yes, it will.
Does it need to be in the sun?
No, it just needs to be in a room temperature area, and you have to water it. So the other thing that Neva Farms is really known for, yes, it's edible flowers.
Ladies, would you like to try one?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I guess so.
I just use the petals myself, just to give it a little bit of color and just a little bit of floral tones.
Fresh, fresh tasting.
How would someone at home get that?
I do believe that they sell this over at Vita Health and Fresh Carrot. I believe they sell them there.
Cool, good to know, okay.
So we're just gonna take a little bit of this cream, and we wanted to whip it just to get some air in there, just so you're not, you know, overdressing your greens and causing them to go and deflate.
So you're using the lightly whipped whipped cream as your dressing?
Yes, that with the fancy vinegar, as you would say. And if you look, just beautiful color that we got going on there. Really light, really fresh. And then we have two final touches, three really, to finish this dish. We have some nice toasted pine nuts. Just going to add in a little bit. I know not everybody likes pine nuts. There's a bit of a metallic taste to them, so you want to go and toast them off to get rid of that metallic taste. And the final, we have this beautiful goat cheese. We're just going to pull that apart. We're just going to take nice big chunks and put that in there. So we're just gonna take the beets out first and put that on the bottom. Our last way to go and finish off this salad, we're just gonna use a little bit of lemon olive oil. This is also a Frescoli product. This lemon olive oil, it's like you're biting right into a lemon.
I love it.
Yeah. He had like a visceral reaction to that.
Here's a question. For those at home who don't have, again, this beautiful fancy olive oil, could we use a little bit of lemon juice then a little bit of regular olive oil?
Or it's just
not the same?
You could, but it is just not the same. And then we're just going to take one last flour, and we're just going to garnish. So this is Beets by Era.
And it looks delicious.
Gorgeous.
Time to taste it. I'm going to have to do a bite. It tastes like my grandma's garden in my mouth. And that is a major compliment. It's fresh, it's delicious. It's everything I want in a beet salad. And there's a flower. Ladies, what do you guys think?
It looks like it's art and it's food. You gotta love anything that's art and food at the same time.
And you are gonna love this. Up next on the menu, we have
fair trade coffee rubbed.
Okay.
Pink peppercorn.
Yes.
Beef satay.
He said it up next here on Meghan's menu. Yeah.
Well done.
Couldn't write down all those yummy recipes in time? MeghanDuffy.ca has everything online, complete with tips from Meghan and Chef. Also, be sure to connect with us on social media to get a sneak peek at upcoming episodes, behind-the-scenes footage, and exclusive news.
Hypnotic is one of Winnipeg's best salons since 2008. From hair to nails and even massages, Hypnotic is where you go to relax. Come and visit us at 1600 Kennison Boulevard. Book an appointment online today.
Hi, it's Sheila Bennett from Kitchen Sink, your place to create.
Do you own or manage a restaurant that you would love to have featured on Meghan's menu? If so, email us and tell us everything about your establishment. But hurry, our next season is booking up fast. If you're interested in being on the show or working with us behind the scenes, we have volunteer opportunities available and we would love to hear from you.
Welcome back to Meghan's Menu. Here joining me is Steve from Arabistro, and of course we have Leanne and Kim. Now, we are going to make this pink peppercorn, fair trade, coffee rubbed steak.
Beef satay. You're
beef
so
satay.
Close.
Beef satay. Oh,
so
I'm close. Working on it over the break. Okay, so why is this dish so popular on your menu?
Well, this is actually one of our more popular banquet items. A lot of people don't know that Arabistro actually caters for the entirety of the Human Rights Museum. We are able to do 1,200 sit-down reception or 2,500 cocktail reception between five locations. And one of the reasons why this is so popular is that we use a lot of fair trade products in it, plus we use a little bit of our local beef from up in Carmen, Manitoba. So our fair trade products that we're using, we have a little bit of pink peppercorn, some black peppercorn, bay leaves, my favorite spice blend, which is literally just cayenne pepper and paprika. A little smoky, a lot of heat.
Do you smoke paprika?
Yes, we do. Spirit Bear Coffee.
Spirit Bear, is that local?
That is, I believe the company that roasted it is local, but they import the beans.
Okay.
And then what I call Nona Spice, it's just garlic powder, onion powder.
You call it a Nona Spice?
Nona Spice.
Like your grandma?
Yeah, like my grandma.
I have a Nona too, but she's not my grandma, she's my Italian neighbor. Hi Nona, she's watching. We love you.
So all we're gonna do, we're gonna take equal parts of the pink peppercorn.
Now, for those watching at home, why do you like using the pink?
It's a softer peppercorn. When you have black peppercorns, it's that spice that you always associate with table pepper. Pink peppercorn, it's a lot milder. It kind of flows over the tongue. It doesn't just stay in the back.
Okay, so half black, half pink.
Yeah. Now, a lot of people think when you use a bay leaf, it's not edible. You can't can't eat it. But if you break it down, you can. We're just gonna take about two or three of these, toss in there, just for a little bit of flavor. When you're grinding them though, you have to grind them with a little bit of peppercorn or clove or something that's a little harder just so it breaks it up. Otherwise, it'll just spin around.
Oh, I can smell that pepper, all right.
Oh yeah. But it's beautiful. If you look at the colors there, you got the pink, the black, the green.
Oh, that is strong.
Oh, it's like pepper fetti.
Like pepper fetti. Pour it into a dish, because what we want to do is we really want to coat this. Take a little bit of our nona spice, and you want to be very heavy on that.
Again, garlic powder, onion powder, and a little bit of love.
Main key here, this beautiful coffee. Now, you should always try and grind your coffee fresh. If you can't, that's all right. Any coffee will work with this. However, it's like wine. If you're cooking with cheap wine, you'll taste it. You're cooking with really good wine, you'll taste it that much more. And then a little bit of fire. So we're just gonna mix that up. A lot of people, when they do their seasoning of the meat, they just kind of sprinkle a little bit. You know, it's not what we want here. Yeah, exactly. It should stick to everything. You wanna be able to taste coffee in every bite.
These are, you said sirloin?
This is strip loin.
Strip loin. If you didn't have strip loin at home, really, could you use any cut of beef?
Yes and no. There's certain types of beef that are better for slower cooking, like chuck for braising.
Right.
And there's certain types like the strip loin, your New Yorks, your tenderloins that do a lot better in the frying pan.
Okay. Okay, so we have a hot pan here. We're gonna drop these in.
So we're just gonna pop that in there, start getting that nice sear on. What we like to do is we'll give it a nice sear in the pan and then we'll finish it in the oven just so it's a softer cook. We want a nice even heat all the way through.
You can see this is just gonna taste delicious.
Oh, yeah. Oh yes, yeah.
And of course, if you didn't write this recipe down, you can go to our website, meganduffy.ca, and it will have everything to do step by step on how to make this in your own kitchen.
So we're just getting a nice little brown on there, just a little caramelization. As you notice, we didn't put any salt on here. We're actually gonna finish with salt. If we over-salt it, it'll just taste salt, it'll overpower the subtleness of the pink peppercorn and the garlic and onion. So you gotta make a nice blend, and you gotta do it all fresh right beforehand.
Okay, Leanne is asking where the beef is. So where is the beef?
It's coming out of the oven right
okay,
now.
Okay, perfect.
So,
oh, look at this now.
What we've done, we have to serve just a little bit of like a cream to go and cut that coffee and cream, it's natural, right? So what we've done, we've taken a little bit of yogurt, and this is just yogurt, cilantro, and lime juice, and it's about, for every cup of yogurt, about 3 limes, so it's quite heavy on the acidity.
Do you put the zest in or just the...
Just the juice.
Okay.
Just the juice. So we're gonna take a little bit of pea shoots.
Can I try a little bit of the sauce?
Of course, and try a little bit of the pea shoots, too.
This tastes like a sorbet I want to eat on a hot summer night. This is delicious.
So we're just gonna put a little bit of these right onto the slate board. And then just to finish it off, we're just gonna do a little bit of drizzle over top.
There we go. Look at that.
How gorgeous is
it's
that?
A piece of art. And we're gonna eat it. We have one more thing because we didn't want to leave anyone out. Da 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 da.
Oh! Oh my gosh! Damn!
The beautiful thing about this rub, it's great on potatoes, it's great on cheese, like the goat cheese you're about to have.
Oh, fantastic.
It's great on fish. It is fantastic.
And it's also beautiful.
Now, be careful, it is very hot.
And I'm gonna make them. So I'm really getting the spice, and the coffee is there, but it's not overpowering.
The coffee comes through. Everything comes through, but nothing is, you don't get like a hint of pepper, and you can still taste the coffee.
But I like that it's peppery, and I think that's why people love this so much.
The lime
but yeah, the lime is where it's at. This sauce is amazing. Good job. This is absolutely wonderful. So up next, we are going to be making...
Our number one selling sandwich at the restaurant is our Pickerel Po-boy.
So ooh! Stay tuned. We have Pickerel Po-boys coming up here on Meghan's Menu. We are having too much fun here. We are in the kitchen with Steve from Era Bistro, and we are about to make one of my favorite sandwiches that I get basically anytime I see it on the menu, which is a fish po'boy. Now, this is Manitoban because we're using pickerel.
Yeah, this is some of the most beautiful pickerel I've had the pleasure of working with. It's from Bearcat Fisheries up north. Now, the recipe that we're gonna do, it actually works really well with any type of fish, especially the ones that we find here in Manitoba, the jackfish, the whitefish. So what you're looking for with pickerel, you want that nice pink flesh, and you want to have a fillet that's about 9 to 10 ounces so that we can cut it down and get it into a nice portion size for your sandwich.
So this is a good, like, just to show people, this is a good size here, hey?
Yeah.
For a sandwich.
Okay, so when we're breaking down this fish, remember, we want to keep this into a sandwich portion. So we don't want to go and cut across. We don't want to chop it up. We're just going to do one nice little piece here. That'll be the bulk of your sandwich. Now we're left over with these two little guys here. We're going to add that in there too. So when it's done, you're going to have a nice little sandwich like that. Since you are an avid fisherwoman, I'm sure you've breaded fish before.
Hey, I can bread a mean fish. Here we go. Okay, so here we have just flour, correct, Steve?
Just flour, and I'm actually just going to toss a little bit of salt in there.
Perfect.
Just so we season it up a little bit.
Okay, then we're just going to hit the egg wash.
Now, when you're doing the egg wash with fish, you want to go and cut it with some kind of milk, water, something to get that egg so it's not so sticky, not so gloopy. Otherwise, you'll have fried egg sandwich.
Literally.
You know, it's funny. Fish is the one thing that people can complain about for it smelling what it is.
Yeah.
Right? But there is a difference between fish smelling bad and fish smelling like fish. If it smells like it's off, it's probably off.
It's off. Ready.
Perfect. So we're just going to put this on the cutting board for now. We'll get some hot oil on.
This is going to go into our hot oil. Okay, so here we go. We have our battered fish here. Mm-hmm. Looks pretty good. We're going to put it right in the hot oil.
Nope, carefully. No one's.
Careful.
There you go. And you're doing it right. Putting the fish away from you. Never put it towards you. You'll splash back up on yourself. So we're just going to brown them. And then same thing. You want to go and transfer them out into another pie pan. Cook them in the oven. Same idea with the beef. You don't want to overcook them.
So you finish in the oven.
Exactly. So we've been frying this for a little while, been flipping it back and forth. Just get a nice little even color on it. Now, a lot of people don't know when fish is done. You wanna go for about a medium to medium well when you're doing pickerel. And while we're waiting for that to cook, we're actually gonna set up our delicious po-boy bun.
Now, do you need a ciabatta bun for this, or really any bun could do?
Anybody can do, whatever you prefer. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna make a nice little po-boy, and we're gonna do a simple toss salad with it. So what I'm gonna get you to do, Meghan.
Yes.
I'm gonna get you to go and slice some tomato for me.
Okay.
Yeah, so every good sandwich needs a good spread. What we do is a nice little caper remoulade. Essentially, it's mayonnaise, a little bit of lemon, a little bit of caper. You just blitz all up in the nice Robocoo, and it's absolutely
blitz good. Blitz it all up in the what?
Blitz it up in the Robocoo.
Like a blender.
A blender, yes.
Okay. Okay, so these are nice and toasty. They look
perfect.
Pretty good.
Perfect.
Perfect. There you go. Our ciabatta. So, to make your own tartar sauce, we have a little bit of caper. We have some lemon.
We have mayo. We have salt, pepper.
Vinegar.
No vinegar in this because the capers are actually pickled. And so it has its own brine in, and that's what we're going to use to get that acidity in there. So we're just going to take
don't
a nice
fair
amount.
Don't be shy on that tartar sauce there.
You don't want the dry bun.
Yeah, you got stingy.
We have some nice leaf lettuce here.
Leafy lettuce.
Gotta love the leaf lettuce.
Gotta love it.
All we're going to do with it, rather than having just lettuce kind of go across it, we're actually going to julienne it up. When you julienne, you want to go and just roll a tight little bundle. Don't crush the lettuce. You don't want to damage your herbs. And then just very thin slices. We have these beautiful cocktail tomatoes. These are from Greenland Garden, another one of our local suppliers from North. All those specialty shops will have these products. Quality ingredients is what you want. And we're also gonna take a little bit of our
so good.
Cucumber that we just sliced up here. We're just gonna toss that in as well. I absolutely love this sandwich. I love all the products we use. Speaking of products we're using, going back to Frescolio, my fancy vinegars and oils.
Right. So what do we have in these two little things?
We have their white balsamic, and then they also have a red apple dark balsamic. Just give that a smell.
That smells so deep. Let me smell this one.
Very rich, and that one's so much sweeter. Ooh. Vinegar.
That took a really big whiff.
Okay, now we're gonna go back to the bun here, and we'll just finish this up, because I believe that pickerel should be coming out of the oven any time now.
I think it's ready.
So we're just gonna take our nice julienne leaf lettuce, put that on top, some of these beautiful Chef Meghan inspired tomato. The last thing that we're gonna put on this, a little bit of pickled onion. Now, when we breaded this, we only did one breading on it. If you double bread it, it gets too thick, and you end up with like a chicken nugget of fish. This way, mainly meat, beautiful crunch on the outside still. You know what, we're just gonna put two on there.
This is a mile high. Yeah, wow.
Okay, so we're gonna put that fresh salad on there. And once again, that's only five ingredients. And then flip that over, press it down just a little bit.
Okay, so here we have our pickerel po-boy. There you go. If you want this sandwich, go and see Steve at Era Bistro. I'm just gonna dig on in. Cheers, guys.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Crunch and flake and chew and fresh all at one shot. Ditto.
The bun is nice because it's nice and soft. It's not over toasted, which I do not like, especially for a fish sandwich. The tartar sauce is unreal and the fish is perfect. This is outstanding. All this and a whole bunch more is on our website. You are absolutely gonna love this sandwich. Up next, we are doing some spearmint strawberry dessert.
Close, spearmint strawberries.
I tried. That's and a whole lot more up next here on Meghan's Menu.
Couldn't write down all those yummy recipes in time? MeghanDuffy.ca has everything online, complete with tips from Meghan and Chef. Also, be sure to connect with us on social media to get a sneak peek at upcoming episodes, behind-the-scenes footage, and exclusive news.
Hypnotic is one of Winnipeg's best salons since 2008. From hair to nails and even massages, Hypnotic is where you go to relax. Come and visit us at 1600 Kennison Boulevard. Book an appointment online today. Hi, it's Sheila Bennett from Kitchen Sink, your place to create.
Do you own or manage a restaurant that you would love to have featured on Meghan's Menu? If so, email us and tell us everything about your establishment. But hurry, our next season is booking up fast. If you're interested in being on the show or working with us behind the scenes, we have volunteer opportunities available and we would love to hear from you.
So it's that time here in the kitchen where we get to do something a little bit sweet. Obviously, I love desserts. Are you guys a sweet tooth? Do you have a sweet tooth?
Maybe a little one.
She's more of a sweet tooth, but I love good desserts.
Perfect. So I see we have some fresh strawberries here. What are we making?
Yeah, so today we're doing spear the berries. During the summer, one of my favorite things to do is to go out to the U-Picks, pick up all the fresh berries that I can, take them home and just be a little kid again, except with alcohol this time. So that's what we're going to do today. And because we are all about the local and simple and all that, we're doing some very simple, great ingredients once again. This is the whipped cream that we were using from earlier. We're just about there. You know, you just want it to start to stand, but you want it a little runny so it also acts as a dressing for the berries. We're gonna grab some other local berries to Manitou. We have some nice Saskatoons, some nice blueberries, just to give it a little bit more color. And what we did is that we actually froze these back in summer and we saw them out. And as you can see, there's a little bit of liqueur in there, eh? Use as much as you want, use as little as you want. If you don't want them at all, don't put them in there, it's fine. So we're just gonna take that, toss it through a little bit. We got some nice pepper.
Pepper?
Pepper. And then we're gonna go and make it a little bit sweet as well with just a little bit of icing sugar. You just want enough to go and coat it. And then
so
we're just gonna toss it through.
Instead of adding salt and pepper, we're adding pepper and sugar.
Pepper and sugar. We have our pepper, we have our sugar, we have our berries, but they're not spirited yet. So we're gonna use some orange liqueur. And we're gonna use quite a hefty bit of it. Same thing, toss it right through. So we're just gonna take a little bit of the berries, try and get a little bit of everything in there, and we're just gonna put it right in the middle. I'm gonna actually try and get some of those blueberries because they seem to be all at the bottom anyways.
And I love that there's Saskatoons in here because not everyone uses Saskatoons.
No, it's a very unutilized fruit from Manitoba, and we have some of the best local Saskatoons around. And then just to finish it off, just a nice dollop that whipped cream. And you want it to be a little
so decadent, does it?
You know, it's holding its shape, but it's a little runny. You want to be able to go and mix your berries through, let the liqueur go.
That needs a peek.
I'm mesmerized by these berries.
They're so good. So good.
That looks beautiful.
And that's all it is. Simple, quick, anybody can do this recipe, and everybody you give it to is gonna love it.
Simple, quick, and delicious. You can't really even tell it's pepper. Mm-mm. If someone said, hey, after you eat the dessert, there's pepper on there, I would never have guessed there's pepper.
But you can just get that hint right at the beginning.
The hint of something. No. Steve, you were right. The pepper works.
Beautiful.
It sure is a beautiful thing.
Now, with fresh berries, you can literally use any liqueur. As long as it's a nice liqueur, like a Kirsch, that'd be perfect.
I'm just happy eating these strawberries. A nice thing about this dessert, too, is that you're not gonna leave feeling super bloated and full and heavy as if it was a piece of cake. So this would be a great one because not only can you share it, but it's nice and light and it's delicious. Who doesn't love fresh, delicious strawberries? I could eat this dessert any day of the week. Thank you, Steve, for joining us here.
No
Ladies,
problem.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for having us.
Again, all these recipes will be on our website, and hopefully we'll see you next time here on Meghan's Menu. Just get a little extra whipped cream.
Ooh, all
Couldn't write down all those yummy recipes in time? MeghanDuffy.ca has everything online, complete with tips from Meghan and Chef. Also, be sure to connect with us on social media to get a sneak peek at upcoming episodes, behind-the-scenes footage, and exclusive news.
Do you own or manage a restaurant that you would love to have featured on Meghan's Menu? If so, email us and tell us everything about your establishment. But hurry, our next season is booking up fast. If you're interested in being on the show or working with us behind the scenes, we have volunteer opportunities available, and we would love to hear from you.
Hi, it's Sheila Bennett from Kitchen Sink, your place to create. What you gonna do with that dessert? Do what, do what, do what?